Casting our future. We're in severe weather season, and we've already seen destructive storms across the country.
Well, there's concern extreme weather events will grow in size and frequency. Some see them as a changing or a symptom of a changing climate.
Now, the country's most famous astrophysicist tells me he doesn't have to look far for a cause or a cure. You know, our climate is always changing.
The sun, over its life, has gotten about 30% more luminous since it was born.
And astrophysicist Dr. Neil deGrasse Tyson says one reason is the way we float in space.
Earth's tilt on its axis actually bobs up and down, and it's not always the same distance from the sun. We have an elliptical orbit.
Tyson says all that creates a slow change over hundreds of thousands of years.
Incredible.
But our weather now, our severe weather, is changing much faster.
And the extreme weather we are seeing has been thrust upon us over a timescale of decades, at most centuries, not millennia.
He says the cause is completely due to what's happening on Earth, not in space.
You can't blame the universe on what we're seeing, no.
You see, to meet its energy and power needs, mankind started digging, mining fossil fuels like coal. And a major element in those fuels is carbon. And Tyson says once that carbon hits the air, it destabilizes it, releasing greenhouse gases, warming the planet, melting the ice caps.
Do you realize if you lose the ice caps on Greenland and on Antarctica, the two largest ice sheets in the world, the water levels of the ocean will rise to the Statue of Liberty's left elbow.
Is there any way then to protect ourselves or to change the narrative?
Well, short of inventing carbon scrubbers, that carbon dioxide scrubbers that can remove the greenhouse gases and then bury it back in the earth where it had come from, if you're not going to do that, then find a way to stop pulling carbon out of the ground. You energy that doesn't have those consequences.
Energy sources like solar, wind, and water.